Bonjour, mademoiselle.
Bonjour. La 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 la. What's she selling?
What do you have there for us, mademoiselle?
A new song for sale, just published, all about Paree.
Oh, I would love to hear it.
Melody, 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 song so melodiously. Melody, melody, my kind of melody, gentle and flowing and free. Soaring above every rooftop, whispering under each tree. Melody, melody, my melody de Paris. Paris is the rain, Paris is the pain of a lover's goodbye. It's the
Mademoiselle, forgive this intrusion, but what is your name?
Christine Daillet.
Christine Daillet. I am Philippe de Chandon, a connoisseur of music and beauty. You waste your time selling songs.
What?
It's true, it's not fair. All Paris should hear your voice. That is how good you are. Have you ever considered a career in the opera?
In the opera?
Yes, well, I can see you have. You'll of course need lessons. A fine, natural voice is not nearly enough, as I am sure you know. Here is my card. I am one of the opera's principal patrons. Present this to Gerard Carrière, the company manager, and he will take care of you. I would take you there myself, but alas, business calls me away. Christine, à tout à l'heure.
The Count de Chandon, the Champagne King, me at the Paris Opera, Paris. Paris, the boulangerie on the square. It's the air of a field for Elysian, a Parisian air. Paris, l'amour. Paris, and toujours if there's one place for me, it is only sea of Paris.
Melody, 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 sung so melodiously.
I'm certain that everything here in the opera house is going to be in order.
But I want to see for myself. Well, what are you waiting for?
One of the stagehands told me I shouldn't go down there.
Monsieur Bouquet, is it possible you no longer wish to work for me?
Oh, no, no, Madame Carlotta, I do very much. I love this job.
Then get going.
Yes, Madame Carlotta.
I want a complete inventory of everything that is down there. Old sets, old costumes. I want to know exactly what it is my husband and I are inheriting.
Everything?
Everything. To the very depths.
Yes, Madame Carlotta. Who's there? Is anybody there? rides out from this place now that all has been changed on this day. Where is the sense of the life that I lead now that music's been taken away? Why was I born in this grave, languishing deep in this tomb? Oh, for an angel of music to come and restore a small glimmer of light to my gloom. Where in the world, in the vast open world, is a voice that can sing? Every note building high, letting free, letting fly like a bird taking wing. Where in the world, if it can be, where is she? What little town hides a girl in a gown with a throat like a lark? With a voice that is strong, who with effortless song makes a light in the dark? Where in the world, where in the world? The caves, in the streets, the cafes, find the one I desire. You will know she is near by a warmth in your ear and your soul catching fire. Out in the world, somewhere, she who was born to command by singing, she with the tone of a bell, the wind is ringing, and she who will hardly suspect what she is bringing to a plan I weave with grand design. Go in the world, don't return from the world till you find me the one with the stance of a queen and an eye as serene and as bright as the sun can shine. Find in the world this mirage that I see, and from the world you will bring her to me, and I'll meet.
Not if the diva has to run an opera company. Every small detail to supervise, every pretty face to screw. Tonight's I plan beneath these eyes, this opera company. Why take on this arduous chore? Sleepless nights I pace across my bedroom floor. Why do I live completely for this opera company? It's mine, from the stalls to the portraits on the walls to the balconies and loges far and near. It belongs all to me, every item that you see, from the cellar to the crystal chandelier, from the fluted marble grand facade to the elevated promenade, from every toilet bowl to every leading roll. This place is mine. I will sing, I will blow, I will never let it go. I will hold it ever captive in my hand. Like a god, like a queen, I will enter any scene and control it like the kingdom I command. And I pity any baritone who attempts to tread the stage I own. With no polite request, he's here at my behest, 'cause it's all mine. My curtain and my canopy, my song, my key, my chart, my grand room and
I'll get them on their feet. I will burn, I will scheme, I will realize my dream, cause if I'm not in a light, I'm incomplete. And the best part I'm just coming to, how they'll all applaud for you know who. I can't believe I'm here, and this is my career. It must be seen like a torch, we'll engrave it on the porch, like an edict, like a beacon, like a sign. This
dry and my knees grow weak at each word, each sound. That voice, that music in the air, every choice, every syllable, each note, how they float, and her tone,
a miracle of silk spun to gold, unfolding in polychrome. And when I hear it, now I know I'm home. Who is this prodigy who sings to only me? She is as innocent and natural as a rose. I'll do her so much good. We two, I know we could combine to make a perfect world, far better than what's outside.
Stand up straight. Breathe. Relax. Now bow. Stand up straight. Relax. Better.
My poor Carlotta, would you like a drink?
Yes. Something mixed with hemlock.
I'll get her a brandy.
No, you're right. These reviews are definitely not good.
Oh.
Joseph Bouquet!
My costume man!
She sent him down below.
Well, someone has sent him back up.
Phantom. The opera's been invaded by a phantom.
The opera's been invaded by a phantom.
The opera's been invaded by a ghost.
By a ghost.
By a ghost.
By a ghost.
By a ghost. If you follow him, you're following a phantom.
A phantom.
The opera's been invaded by a phantom.
A phantom.
The opera's been invaded by a phantom.
A phantom.
The opera's been invaded by a ghost.
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 If you hurry and you scurry, perhaps you should be worrying. And hurrying
and
scurrying
may lead you prematurely to your end. You may.
imagined you. Do re mi fa sol fa re fa mi. Do re mi fa sol fa re mi do. Now you.
Do re mi fa sol fa re fa mi. Do re mi fa sol fa re mi do.
Move the do. Do re mi fa sol fa re fa mi. Do re mi fa sol fa re mi do.
Do re mi fa sol fa re fa mi. Do re mi fa sol fa re mi do.
You were the best, you win the prize. You made the night effervescent, the voice, the dress, the lows, the highs. It was beyond incandescent. Can it have been I who first found you? Can these be my arms now around you? Such poetry, can you be real? Or are you someone imagined? Who could ever have dreamed up you? What kind of mind could ever have made that face? There couldn't be two in heaven and earth like you. One of a kind, like holding two pair of aces. I was nothing and nowhere till now, but from this moment I'll only go where you go. I hope he's taking a bow. Whoever knew what to do, met someone wonderful who once dreamed of you. Oh, Christine, I'm in love with you. Totally gone, defeated and all askew. I'm feeling it start, a craziness over you. Lead the way on, no matter to where I'll follow. Love completely adoring and you. Can you believe I feel myself soaring? It's true, I love you. And from the very first moment that I saw you, it's really true, c'est vrai absolument.
Tell me once again, tell me once again. On a scale of 10, was I maybe 6 or 7?
More.
Don't exaggerate, 7.5 or 8. Any more than that, I'd be in heaven.
Oh, Christine, I'm in love with you.
Can it even be? Did I hit the G?
I'm gone.
Did I make the trill? Never mind, I will.
And all ask you a love.
Was I really good?
Adoring and you.
Did I move the way I should?
Can you believe I feel myself soaring? It's true, I love you.
Billy, please wait just a moment. The words you say, the things I feel, are getting a bit confusing. Some things you know, some things you don't. It complicates what I'm choosing. Much to absorb and to ponder, my heart just as yours, growing fonder. I hate to speak, perhaps next week I'll come to an understanding. Who would ever have dreamed of this, that I'd be I'd love to kiss. It's something so pure, it almost approaches bliss. The kind of gift that comes to so very few.
Oh, someone wonderful must have dreamed of you.
malicious eyes. Safe from all venomous words and malicious lies. Sleep, gentle creature, my love and my protege. As for myself, I will worship you night and day. All my existence will end if you go away. Life without your music would be not worth living. I'd be useless as a bell that cannot ring. Sad abandoned king, without a land to live for. Life without your sweetness, bleak, dead, incomplete, a season silent as a bird that doesn't sing. Endless frozen time can turn to spring. Without your spell, like a musical chord running deep in my mind, like a swell in a classical symphony, I am undone, out of step, out of tune. I'm a man who's gone blind, broken inside.
More than
My mother bore me in the southern wild. I live in darkness, but my soul is light. Light as the forehead of an English child. But I'm in darkness and bereaved of light. My mother taught me underneath a tree, and sitting down before the heat of day, she took me on her lap and kissed me, and pointing to the east, began to say, upon the rising sun, their God does live and gives his light and gives his heat away. And all the trees and flowers and beasts and men receive their comfort from the morning through the bright noonday. And put on earth a little space, that we may learn to bear the beams of love, and these poor bodies and this ravaged face are but a cloud, and like a shady grove. For when our souls have learned the heat to bear, the clouds will vanish, we will hear his voice saying, come out from the grove, my love and care, and round my golden tent like lambs rejoice. Thus did my mother say and kissed me. And thus I say to little English boy, when we are both from light and dark clouds free, and round the tent of God we both rejoice, I will shade him from the heat till he can bear to lean in joy upon our father's knee. And then I'll stand and stroke his silver hair and be like him, and he will then love me. Voices in my night will cry, of rain that falls will be Christine. You were the only one, my only chance of happiness, my golden leaf of autumn, my Christine. Look within this heart of mine, Christine, the very constant soul and music of Christine. Behind this mortal mask, this terror of a face conceals the gesture and the grace of you, Christine. No one else must ever have Christine. If not for me, you'll be for no one else, Christine. If I am guilty, I'll be guilty of that innocence whose name is love. And never, no, you'll never be for anyone except for I damn you, when I love you, and I love you, and I damn you, my Christine.
Thank you. became my whole life when your life was begun. Do you know that the man who protected you always has been your father?
Yes, I know I'm your son, and I more than surmise. I have known for some years that my eyes are your eyes. And I've wondered how long it would take you to tell me it's true.
Now that you know, I must tell you, I'm grateful for you.
No, it is I who am grateful to you.
Life of perpetual darkness and rain, for inside you the light of the soul of your mother has shone. Eric, you are my son and my boy and my life and my own.
And what did you think of it?
Think of what?
Your infant's face.
Ah, it could have been better.
You remember the day I looked down into the water?
Yes.
I thought I'd seen a sea monster.
I remember.
I had. That's the irony. And then, for a while, I thought I was only dreaming.
I went through that phase, too.
Not a good face for a tenor, I remember thinking.
Not even for a baritone.
It is a good voice, isn't it?
Very good. You would have had a fine career.
Will you bury me deep? I must never be found. When at last I find sleep and I'm cold in the ground.
Yes, I promise I'll never allow you to be on display.
My boy and my...